That's my baguette. As fun as it is making fun of video games with annual releases, I gotta give credit to Ubisoft for making completely different locations for us to explore in their games. However, more than ever, I found myself as well as others feeling a large sense of fatigue from the Assassin's Creed series. What most certainly proves our point is the fact that not only do two Assassin's Creed games come out this year, but they both come out on the exact same day. Assassin's Creed Rogue for the Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3, and the game we'll be reviewing today, Assassin's Creed Unity, which is only available on the PS4, Xbox One, and PC. Being the first exclusive Assassin's Creed game on the next gen, is Unity the revolution that'll spice up the stealth and action genre, or is it just more of the same? For the record, I like to say that personally, the overall plot and modern stories in the Assassin's Creed series suck. I mean, I've never liked them, and I was only interested in what was going on during the time period we're exploring. Luckily, just like Assassin's Creed 4, Unity disregards everything that's happened in the past games and decides just to do its own thing. In the current world, you, the player, are playing a video game made by Stergo Entertainment. Midway through a level, your system is hacked by an assassin in need of your assistance. They want you to explore 18th century France looking for the precursor artifacts from the civilization that came before. Honestly, don't give a shit. I just care about what's going on in the past. You take control of Arno Victor Dorian, who is the best character in the series since Ezio. You've been framed for murder and decided to join the Assassin Brotherhood to take down important targets and to figure out who killed your foster parent. While the story isn't anything game-changing, I found myself invested into hunting down each target just so I could be one step closer to the killer. The story is straightforward and to the point, and I didn't mind this at all, although the ending in particular is as bad, if not worse, than most Assassin's Creed games. Like mentioned previously, I like Arno. He's a mischievous and curious young guy who is sometimes irrational and sloppy, although I don't know why his new assassin buddy calls him Pisspot all the time.
Where he staring at, Pisspot?
Goodbye, Pisspot!
Took you long enough, Pisspot.
The relationships he has with other characters feels genuine, particularly with his love interest. And albeit short, I actually cared about the love story in this game. It must be a coincidence considering the game takes place in Paris. And it doesn't hurt that this game probably has the best kissing in any game. I'm pretty creepy. To those of you wondering, yes, this game does look next-gen, but it's not without its flaws. If you look at still screenshots of the game, it looks fantastic, but multiple glitches, short draw distances, and a chugging frame rate at around 20 holds the game back from looking near perfect. But the attention to detail and the overall big picture is astounding. Lighting is stellar, walking through rich mansions is nothing short of impressive, facial animation is great, and when thousands of NPCs roam the streets, it's honestly unlike anything you've ever seen in a game before. Paris is as fully realized as any other location in the Assassin's Creed series. Take away the fact that the game takes place during the disgusting French Revolution, I would have loved to live there. The mass amounts of color and the different districts that make up Paris further bring the city to life. I enjoy running around Paris so much that I sometimes find myself panning the camera ever so slowly just to take in the view. And all that fog you see? That's actually a combination of BO from all the French people. The game's soundtrack is as good as any other Assassin's Creed game. It feels epic, it sets the mood for where the game takes place. And those rare moments where they play the riff from the series' main theme gave me goosebumps and made me feel just a tad emotional. My only other problem with the presentation is the voice acting. Now, I'm not saying it's bad, it's impressive to be honest. The overall cast, especially the actor of Arno, showed genuine emotion and believability. The writing represents French culture nicely too, but if you're gonna get actors to speak French with French accents, please don't hire British voice actors. This never bothered me until a friend pointed it out for me, and now I'll never stop thinking about it.
So, Who or what will take its place? Another king? A council of capable men?
That is the question, isn't it?
The gameplay foundation for the Assassin's Creed series is still the same. Parkour on buildings that are built like a playground, and assassinate bad guys. It's good to note though that both of these elements are improved and easily make Assassin's Creed Unity the most strategic and satisfying game in the series. Free running, while still not 100% perfect, is much more refined, accurate, and looks much cooler. Only a couple of times did the system fail on me. Other than that, scaling huge buildings was fluent and easy, while jumping across from building to building looked amazing and makes me feel like an instant badass. The new feature they added to free running was the ability to hold down a button that lets you go down buildings with incredible ease. While it may seem like an obvious addition to add to a game about climbing, it's so convenient that it baffles me how they didn't even add this feature in any game of the series beforehand. While they have tweaked the combat system a little bit, there's nothing new here for series veterans. All you do is sneak around and silently kill bad guys. If you screw up, you end in a very heated sword fight. Unlike past installments, head-on combat is much more difficult. It's much less obvious when enemies attack, and there's little room for failure. It only takes a couple of mistakes to die at the hands of your enemies, so the game strongly encourages you to take the stealth route, and there are many additions in this regard that make sneaking around much easier. Unity finally has a stealth button, which lets you walk around all crouched up to silently and quickly assassinate your enemies. Eagle Vision is back, but can only be used for a limited amount of time. So little time, in fact, that I found this to be quite a tease and just decided to complete the game without using it. There's also a cover system, but it's incredibly clunky. I sometimes can never tell if I'm in cover, whether the enemy can see me, and sometimes I find it hard to exit cover in quiet fashion. New items arise too, like the Phantom Blade. And while there isn't any footage of this, the Phantom Blade is the same hidden blade all assassins have, except with a mini bow that lets you kill enemies silently from afar. It's easy to use and comes in handy in both loud and quiet encounters. You also have smoke bombs, similar to what you had in Assassin's Creed Revelations, and they are incredibly useful. Almost too useful. Even in the most difficult situations, one smoke bomb will leave your enemies vulnerable to insta-kill or give you an easy chance to run away. Gameplay-wise, the biggest and the best new addition to the series is mission design. I know, this doesn't sound so exciting, but this is exactly what I've wanted from the series. Instead of being forced to follow a linear path and having many restrictions for combat, you could tackle most missions however you want. Do you climb up the building and hop through the window? Or do you tail on the fort with valuable information? Or you could create a distraction and sneak through the main entrance. The amount of freedom the game bestows upon you isn't huge, but it's a step in the right direction for the series.
Grandmaster cannot fail to recognize our work.
As you say, monsieur.
Unity takes out its infamous competitive multiplayer and replaces it with four-player co-op. You all watch a cutscene that explains your current mission, and then you do as you please. These missions actually give you more freedom than the campaign missions do. And while it sounds like fun playing with three other fellow assassins, I found it super unenjoyable when I was playing with three complete strangers. With limited communication options and a hit of competitive play, playing with other assassins quickly turns into a race to see who can get the most kills the fastest. So if you're considering playing the co-op missions in the game, it is highly recommended that you play with friends that you trust will actually assist with the mission. Completing any mission, whether single player or co-op, rewards you with cash and points to help upgrade Arno. Unlike previous games where you're rich as balls and can literally buy anything, Unity's economy is balanced and asks you to spend your money wisely. Money gets you new pieces of armor that changes up your stats as well as how you look, and the awfully named Creed points lets you upgrade different traits of your character. Larger amount of health, decreased fall damage, better lockpicking skills, or even the ability to learn new tricks that will help you become the ultimate assassin. You can also change the color scheme of your character, and anyone that knows me personally knows that the first that I'm going for is purple. And after meeting specific requirements, you can also dress up like previous characters in the Assassin's Creed series, like Altair, Ezio, and Connor. And then there are microtransactions. In my opinion, It's disgusting. Enough said. It takes around 13 hours to complete the main story. Replay value consists of finding chests, further upgrading your character, playing the multitude of side missions, both single and co-op, and you can also try the Heliex missions. These missions transfer you to a different time period in Paris and do crazy shit. Although there is a large amount of things to do in this game, I feel after I've beaten the main story, there's nothing left for me to do. There was no reason to complete other missions, search for all the collectibles, or even play with my friends. It may have been because of the absence of competitive multiplayer, or the lack of real purpose following the completion of the game. I found this to be particularly disappointing. While not much has changed, Assassin's Creed Unity showcases the best and worst aspects of the series. Open mission design, wonderful recreation of Paris, and an interesting story and main protagonist makes this game a personal favorite of mine in the series. But compared to its predecessor Black Flag, Unity overall feels like a step backwards. This is, however, still a really great game. If you like Assassin's Creed, you'll like Unity. But like others, if you're starting to get sick of the series, nothing here is gonna get you excited. Assassin's Creed Unity receives an 8 out of 10. Thank you for watching Bathroom Gamers. For more reviews, be sure to subscribe and blah blah blah. It's not what's important right now. What is important is the amount of games that have been released this week alone. This week saw the release of Little Big Planet 3, Dragon Age Inquisition, Far Cry 4, the next-gen version of Grand Theft Auto 5, and today, Super Smash Bros. For the Nintendo Wii U was released. So, as busy as it is, here's my schedule. The next review will be of Far Cry 4, then Super Smash Bros., and then Little Big Planet 3. If anyone's interested in a review for Dragon Age Inquisition, let me know in the comments below. And if there are any other games you want me to review in the future, please be sure to have those in the comments as well. Thank you for watching, and stay fresh.